I can't believe I drew the pick the first game. I played, I drew the pick. I know I'm a freshman, but freshmen don't throw picks like that. And they choose tails and another guy. The other guy. So we end up on defense first. And we take him. Oh, it's raining.
We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. Kicks it off. Number 12 takes it from the 6. This quarterback is the leader of this team, but he's going to need some help from his offensive line today as they go up against a very good pass rush.
You got that right, Brad. He's the focal point of this offense, and the defensive line knows it. They're going to be coming after him hard today.
When you're as good as this kid is at playing quarterback, there's definitely a bullseye painted on your chest. We'll see how he handles the pressure.
First and 10.
For the first video, we was trying to find a good college, and we did. With number 2 in the league. So let's see. I don't know who number 1 is, but it's not Alabama.
They'll throw on first down. He lets it go.
Oh, no! No, they cheated. Nah, they cheated. They cheated. They cheated. Watch this. Watch this. Look. Look. He drills it up. I'm right in front of him. In front of him. That was a pick right there. A pick right there. But nah, they don't want to give me my pick. Salty. Give us the ball.
And he hits the PAT. And now let's take a look at the drive summary brought to you by Pontiac.
Cheater. Looks like grandma's.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Kicks it off.
They really did cheat it. That was luck. That was it. Hey, get up, bro. He tried to spin.
Before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. They'll set up shop at the 14-yard line. Tennessee comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Rolls right, he's looking. Across the middle, and they make the stop. A 7-yard gain that time from the play-action pass completion. It's second down and 3 to go. Ball on their own 21. Tennessee lines up in a double tight set. Nice play fake.
Over the middle. And it's still caught. It's still caught. Let's go.
Brought down.
Nice decision by the quarterback.
Not only was it good decision making, but the offensive line protected just long enough for him to find his target.
And when you combine the two, it'll be a first down 9 out of 10 times.
First and 10.
I was about to get sacked, saying it was doing good.
Three wideouts here. They'll bring him down. And the halfback ripped off a nice gain there to get him the first.
Hey, this kid's a good-looking back. Let's see if they go to him again.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. They line up in an eye. Pressure comes. Looking. And they get the sack.
Why y'all not blocking?
That sack, guys.
Yeah, the offensive line couldn't adjust to them sending the added pressure. And the result was a nice play on the defensive end.
You're absolutely right. Those big uglies up front didn't know who to block.
Second and long coming up here. Ball on the 37.
No answer me nothing while I'm running out option. I'm running out option.
Tennessee comes out of the shotgun. The option left. Pitches back. He's on the run. Tackle. Excellent run that time, but it still won't be enough to move the chain. It's third down and 8 to go. Ball right around midfield. The ball come out
showing three wide. Drops back to pass. Rolling out to the right side. He's going right. Finds his receiver inside the 30. And they make the stop. And they convert the third down with a long pass play.
You're right, Brad. And that was a long pass play. As a coach, you got to appreciate it when your players come out and perform like these kids are doing right now.
First and 10. This is the seventh play of this drive. The Volunteers line up with three wide. They'll run the option. And he stopped behind the line. He may have been seriously injured on that play.
Why are you injured your chest?
He's definitely in a lot of pain down there. You really hate to see something like that happen.
What's that one though? How you injure your chest?
It's second down and
11. Somebody kick you or something?
And this is the eighth play of the drive.
Yeah, this is the eighth play of the ball.
Come out in a shotgun. He drops back. And here's a quick throw. Spin move. A 1 yard loss.
Come on, man.
The offense faces another third down as they line it up. Tennessee lines up in a shotgun set. Back to pat. Look.
Swatted away. The ball was knocked to the ground.
Players use anything they can to get in the way of a pass.
I can't even throw the, that thing on ball. Yeah, look at my boot. That was kind of camping.
Line it up for the field goal. The kick is up. And he hooked it left.
What you banking your head on, your fingers?
Take over at the 21.
You should know for me as I mean quarterback. Small four.
Number four lines up in the shotgun. Drop back to pass. Steps up. Wants to throw outside.
Let's go.
He's got his receiver with nobody around him.
That was out of bounds.
Execute, move a little closer to the sticks.
That was out. Complete. I want to challenge the play. Well, he can't challenge the play. He was up. He stepped out.
Second and three. Ball on the 28-yard line. Gets the ball. No, they faked it. Over the middle. Hot. And he's taken down.
I like the defense that was called. They just didn't make the play on the ball.
You're right. It wasn't necessarily bad defense. The offense just executed, and the result was the first down.
Oh, you got a broken leg.
Ball on the 47.
A broken leg.
The Blazers go with the I formation.
I think the Blazers with the Dragons. Don't make no type of sense.
Get it out there on the clock.
Get behind the line.
And
get close
to the backfield. A loss on that one as he couldn't get past those big linemen.
You got that right. They sacrificed their bodies in there and stuffed it.
Second down and 14. Ball on their own 43. They line up in an eye.
This is me later. I think I dangle when he's so slow when he's trying to run through the line.
Back to pass. He lobs it left. Loose football.
Let's go.
And the defense picks it up. Got an opening. The 10. Touchdown.
Let's do it.
And that was about the worst thing you could ask for.
Oh, that hurts.
He didn't even touch the ball.
And now you've got to regroup and try to get back up.
Yes, he did.
For another set of downs.
That was my play. That was my game. Defense did something. He stopped the potential touchdown, because I know he was going to throw it. And it's good. Down the
and he hits the PAT. Less than two to go in our first quarter of play. The score, Tennessee, 7. UAB, 7. Tennessee, the kick.
He's scoring every.
He hits a
scoring on defense. Kick. He might have nailed it.
Number 12.
I know he's ready to go.
Not sure the defense will be trying to strip the ball once again.
These kids don't start hanging out
is making this worse. That's what.
Play action. He lost the ball.
Another fumble.
Number 34 recovers a loose ball. Are they lucky or what? The quarterback very fortunate that one of his guys recovered the football.
Yeah, he's got to be more careful out there. Either tuck that thing away or just get down before contact.
I don't care what he does. Just don't fumble. That's all. Do whatever you have to do to protect that football.
Watch the linebacker. He's the star of the defense, and he's in the zone right now. Inside give. Move. He's got an opening, and he's tackled. And that one goes for a big, big first down.
You know, every time you run the ball successfully like that, that defense starts to creep up a little bit. That's when you go to the air, my friend. Over the top.
Over the top.
The Blazers come out in a two tight end set. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. There's a stiff arm. And down he goes. 7 yards.
What's stiff arm with that?
7 yard gain on the play. Second and three. All on their own 35.
What's stiff arm with that?
UAB lines up with three receivers. They snap it to the back. Up in the backfield. Nice tackle to bring him down before he got back to the line of scrimmage.
Solid effort there.
Play. Solid effort.
Coming up. This is the fifth play of this drive.
This is the fifth and last play of the drive.
UAB comes out in the shotgun. He's looking, throws back across field, has his fullback. Nice stop by the defense.
Well, they let him catch it, but they were not going to let him get that first down.
UAB lining up the punt.
Yeah, so I hate this emulator. It makes everything move so slow.
Booming punt. Fields it for 17.
How you block? How you block to stop blocking and block again?
And we're all tied up. They'll start this drive at the 25-yard line.
I'm gonna hit my other tight end.
Throws this one out to the right. To the middle.
No.
And his tight end.
Really?
And the ball hawking safety scoops it out. What do you think about the play of that safety, Herbie?
This guy stepped up and made a big play right here for the defense. Nice fumble recovery.
Really? This dude caught the ball and fumbled. I said, my tight end. I hit him.
Look to capitalize on a good field position here.
I got number two in the league, in the school, in the whole nation.
Goes with the ace set.
And y'all just fumble a good pass.
Play by the defense that time as they swallowed him up before he got back to the line.
It's more like they devoured him. He had no shot of breaking clean.
Second and 11 coming up. Ball on the 48-yard line. Single set backfield. Counter play. Tackle. The running back gets two on the carry. Third and nine. Ball on the 46-yard line. UAB lines up for the shotgun set. Drops back to pass. Throws. And he's tackled. That play was designed to pick up a first down, but they didn't do it.
It looks like the receiver just lost track of where he was on the field.
The special teams coach sends his punt team out on the field. Number 86 boots it way up there. Number 33 fields it in the end zone.
First and foul.
It's first and 10, ball on the 21-yard line. One man backfield. There's a play fake. Throws to the middle. Batted ball. He's lucky that pass fell innocently to the turf.
Yep, total coverage on that one. Gotta pick his destinations better.
Y'all about to go off in a few seconds.
So it's second and 10, ball on their own 21. The ball set up in the gun. He drops back across the middle, and that one's fallen incomplete, and he overthrew his wide receiver.
I don't know too many 7 foot guys play football, so maybe he should aim lower the next time.
Third and 10, ball on the 21.
This is one out to make it one again.
Number 7 with 3 wide receivers. Back to pass. Look down the middle. Someone got a hand on it.
He's asking to get picked off.
That was a close one, all right. If no one's open, there's nothing wrong with tucking it in and trying to pick up the first on the ground.
I can't tuck it in because I don't know how to tuck it in.
The Volunteers line up with 4 wideouts. He's looking. Throws it out there.
Oh, Dizzy's here.
And it falls incomplete. I wonder why they went for it there.
Yeah, me too. It's still early in the game to have to gamble like that. You have to question the play calling there. That puts a lot of pressure now on their defense.
Can you shut up, please? Like, seriously? Let me play how I play. I play like really backyard football.
On the ground with a tailback. He jukes it. And down he goes.
That juke was so stupid.
Incredible effort there, running the football by this guy.
Okay, yeah, 85 total yards.
The Blazer set up in the gun.
Man, it's time to get serious. It's time to get physical. Physical.
High snap as he works from the gun. Gets past the tackler. And they make the stop.
What the hell is that? If that was an impact tackle, then I mean, Stephon, then he didn't do it right. But I was still in the ground. I mean, he's still on my feet.
They've got all the big boys in for this one. Toss. Tries to juke. Touchdown, UAB. Good idea giving it to the halfback near the end zone.
Why wouldn't you give it to this guy? He told me before the game, if he gets the ball inside the 10, you can 5-star lock it. He's going to score.
And he tacks on the extra point. Here's the drive summary brought to you by Pontiac. UAB is ready to kick it away. Number 21 and number 33 back ready to return. Kicks it off. Number 21 fields it in the end zone. Their last drive ended when they decided to try for it on fourth down and were turned away by the defense. They'll go to work at the 17-yard line.
I feel sexually violated because something is touching me underneath my chair.
The Volunteers come out in the ace formation. They'll throw on first down. Finds a man. He's on the run. At the 40. Down the sideline.
That was a big-time play and a new set of downs.
I think the defense might have been thinking run there, Coach.
Well, I don't blame them. It's pretty common to see a run on first and second down, but this offense is keeping them guessing.
It's first and 10.
I wanted to get around and you're disgusting.
6 DBs in the lineup. On the ground, right side. Has some daylight. He spins around, brought down. And that was a nice run. Kirk, that was a great job by that big offensive line.
Yeah, it really was, Brad. And also, a nice read by the ball carrier to find that running lane.
When you break one like that, you got to give a lot of credit to the offensive line.
Tennessee goes with the ace set here. He rolls out to the right. He fires right. Complete on the run. Touchdown, Tennessee. The throw to the wide receiver goes for a touchdown.
That kid looks like a natural receiver out there.
Well, you could say he's from a good pedigree when it comes to football. I think his father's taught him very well.
Look at that. That dime. Boom. That's mine. At least something good came out of the game. 1-for-2.
They're crowding the line. They don't get the two.
The coach made a big call there, but they just couldn't execute, and they end up still trailing by a point.
Hmm. Okay,
and
they get
the ball. They're ready for the kickoff. We should have a return on this one. Number 11 fields it at the one. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive. They'll get the ball here at the 17.
Now winning. We're showing
from the shotgun. Inside handoff. And they got him for a loss. UAB takes a timeout. Second and 10. Ball on the 17. The Blazers line up with two tight ends. Shakes off a tackle, and he's taken down. Picked up big yards there, and he's going to have a first down.
Yeah, nice job there. This guy does a good job of reading his blocks and accelerating through the hole.
Well, I think it was really disgusting. I still got more yards than them. They got a lot of rushing yards.
The Blazers come out in the shotgun. They'll throw on first down with the throw. And it's caught. Way to look it in. And the pass is caught, but he goes nowhere.
Yeah, nice job there by the defense to get to him and make the sure tackle before he can make any moves to break loose.
Second and 8 coming up here. Ball in the 32.
Dude, we gotta do this good.
Number 4 has 5 receivers lined up here. Wants to throw outside. Down the sideline. To the 20. To the 10. Goodbye.
I hate it.
And he just hauled in his second touchdown catch of the day.
The defense needs to put somebody on this guy before he does some serious damage.
Getting pressure on the quarterback.
I should have pressed.
Can't let this guy play.
I should have pressed. Square. Yeah, square before. Somebody press train.
And he hits the PAT. And now we're going to take a look at the Pontiac drive summary.
They got the punt kicking.
UAB to kick. Number 21 and number 33 set to return. Kicks it off. Number 33 fields it at the 2. Wasn't much of a problem the last time this offense had the ball as they were able to get it in for 6. They'll set up shot at the 30.
Yeah, at the 30.
The Volunteers come out of the ace formation. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. And they make the stop. How about that call in this situation, guys?
No. Not a good one. Let me tell you why. Here's a situation where you want to score and score quickly. That play didn't go anywhere, but it also hurt them in terms of lost time.
Shut up. Man.
Ace backfield drops back to pass.
Come on.
UAB calls a timeout. Here's a third and long situation. Ball on their own 24.
Well, that was trying to draw it to O.
And they have three receivers. He drops back. Look.
Circle. Wide open.
To the outside. Got him on the run. Good yardage on that completion.
The interesting thing about this play is the fact that they ran the same play two times in a row. And I'll tell you what that means. That means that the coach has seen some sort of a mismatch out there.
The ball. Line up with three receivers bunch. Steps up in the pocket. Wants to throw outside. He's knocked out of bounds.
Now, that was a good-looking play. The quarterback put it where his receiver could get it, and now they have a first down.
What I like is the faith that this quarterback has in his receiver. He's not afraid to throw it downfield.
First and 10, and this is the fifth play of the current drive. The Volunteer come out in the ace formation. Back to pass. Rolls right. He's going to go for the home run. It falls incomplete.
That's okay.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. UAB brings in the nickel here. Drop back to pass. Throws it to the outside. Incomplete.
It is hit.
The defense will try to stop this third down as they were unsuccessful the first time on this drive. Tennessee comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. Rolling out to the right side. Throws this one out to the right. He gets another, and this is a big one.
That's just airing it out on third down.
That was more than enough to pick up the first down. Next time, this defense will be playing on their heels.
Come on, we got to score. This is going to be a touchdown for Nick.
Tennessee comes out.
Nick first rushing touchdown.
He's looking.
Nick first.
And they pick up 4 yards on the scramble.
What? No, that was a touchdown. That was a touchdown. The ball even. That was a touchdown. The ball past the foul line. Dang, they better give me my touchdown back. I need my touchdown.
The ball line up with three receivers bunch. On the ground with a tailback. And down he goes. He may have gotten back to the line of scrimmage. Tennessee takes a timeout. See if they can punch this one in. He dropped back. Touchdown, Volunteer. The quarterback didn't see anyone open and decided to scramble.
He made the right call on that one because he got six.
Ace backfield, back to pass. Rolls to the right, looking. He decides to run with it. Down to just a few seconds left here before the half. And our score, Tennessee, 21. UAB, 21. Number 25 is lined up to kick this one off.
Just getting in to hurry up.
Kicks it off. Number 11 takes it at the 4. Yuku. Flag down, and I'm not sure
Clipping.
Where it was thrown. Let's find out.
Clipping. I know what it was.
Back after that costly penalty, and they'll have to try to get that yardage back here.
I thought he was clipping.
First and 10, ball on the 15-yard line.
It's always clipping. When somebody break loose like that, it's always clipping.
UAB lines up in a shotgun set.
22, 22.
They'll give it off here. Down. Nice game for the halfback.
That time they kept it on the ground with the counter play. The blocking was great up front, and the tailback was able to get into the open field and do some special things.
UAB sets up in the eye. And we'll go into halftime here.
We get the ball back.
UAB with a kicking off to start the second half.
And
kicks it deep. Number 21 fields it in the end zone. Spins upfield. So before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. They'll start this drive at the 20. With two tight ends. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. And he puts it on the turf. And I think the big guy spell on it for the defense.
Like, when we do something good, it's
and
always something.
Change in momentum right here, Kirk.
And you know what? When the other offense takes the field, I say they go for the home run on the very first play.
I like your thinking, Kirk. They always say defense is most vulnerable after a turnover.
That's right, Coach.
How you fumble?
Shots, that's what I would do.
I wish it was raining, though.
They're on the right side.
How you fumble?
They start this drive.
How do you fumble? Everything.
UAB goes with the ace set here.
Boy, fatty.
Nice play fake. He's looking for his man. The ball is tipped. Fantastic
play
by the cornerback.
All you young defensive backs at home. That is how you
come on.
Second and 10.
Come here.
Ball on the 22.
Come on. Sit.
Number 33 is in the zone and looking to make something happen. Throw short, and it's the senior. He's into the open field.
Way to look it in. Nice catch.
Sure was. He displayed some great hands there. Now we're looking at a first down.
This is the kind of running back who can make you pay when he's in the zone. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Great play, taking him down behind the line of scrimmage.
And he shot out of his stance like a cannon and exploded into the backfield.
And he stopped behind the line. That brings up third and goal. This is the fifth play of this drive. They line up in the shotgun. Throws this one out to the right. Someone got a hand on it. A lost opportunity there.
When you have a chance to make an interception in the end zone, you gotta make the play.
He could have ended that scoring drive right there, but you'd rather give him another shot.
Here we go. They'll try to make this a field goal game. He gets it up, and it's good. And now we'll take a look at the Pontiac drive summary. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. Number 33 fields it in the end zone. So before the offense hits the field, let's take the time to let you know that our game is brought to you by EA Sports. They'll take over at the 30.
Y'all, stop doing that. Don't put y'all license tags on my game.
Tennessee lines up in a double tight set. Setting up the play action. Looks. He keeps it. And now he's got room to run with the spin. And they make the stop. He had a whole lot of room to run on that one.
When the pressure's coming from the inside and the quarterback can escape the pocket, it usually means he's going to have some room to run.
First and 10. Ball on their own 45. Tennessee comes to the line. Only one man in the backfield. Play action. He throws it.
He caught it. Let's go. Oh,
it's dropped. Dropped by the wideout.
could have caught
down and 10 to go. Ball on the 45-yard line. Single set backfield. Back to pass. He rolls out to the right. He's looking. Wants to throw outside.
Come on, tight end.
Almost a turnover.
As a quarterback, I can tell you that those are the only types of drops we like to see.
Third down and 10 coming up. Ball on the 45. They line up in an eye. Here's the give. And he's tackled. And that is going to be enough for the first.
Is this kid amazing or what, Kirk?
Well, absolutely, Lee. You and I talked about him earlier in the game. What impressed me there is he knew exactly where he needed to go to get the first down the whole time.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 45. Number 21 is feeling it, and he wants the football in his hands. They'll throw on first down. He's rolling right. He takes off. Here's an opening. And down he goes. He made a real nice play on that one.
I'll tell you what. In today's game, you have to have the ability to run the football. Give the quarterback a lot of credit. He made a great play and really gave his team a boost.
First and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line. Tennessee lines up in a shotgun set. Here's the option. And he's hit hard. Nowhere to go there on the quarterback keeper. Second and 13 coming up here. And this is the seventh play of the current drive. Number seven, back in the gun. Nice play fake. Rolls right, looking. Going for it all to the end zone. Got a stat for us, coach.
Why does this stat not surprise me? With that catch, his total yards for the day is over 100.
Pressure turns up when in the red zone, and that's when you turn to Old Spice Red Zone, when performance matters the most.
I just told you.
Red zone visit resulted in a touchdown. Let's see if the defense can hold him this time. And he just found the end zone for the second time today.
And as a defense, the last thing you want to do is give up rushing touchdowns to the quarterback.
They might want to make some changes. Maybe use a linebacker or a safety as a spy next series.
Fat boy, you black? Fat boy. You black?
And he tacks on the extra point. So we take a moment to check out the Pontiac drive summary. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff.
I feel like Kyler Murray in there.
He hits a booming kick. Number 11 fields it in the end zone. Good job on their last drive, getting three. See if they can get some more on this drive. They're behind right now, and I don't think they played their best football in the first two quarters. However, that's not to say that this quarterback hasn't been tearing it up. He's looked great so far.
So much for thinking he wouldn't have enough time to pass.
Yeah, Coach, I don't think those defensive ends got to him one time in the first half.
Nope, not once, Kirk. If they keep giving him all day to throw, then they're going to see him come back, take the lead.
Yeah, we got an injured player on the field.
Yeah. Yeah. You want to run. You're not me. Now you got to put in your backup quarterback.
Second down and five. Ball on the 25.
You want to run. You're not me. He in the backfield by himself. He in a one shot.
Five receivers lined up here. Look.
Good sack.
Bring him down for a sack on the play. Now that's some heavy pressure.
It all starts with the battle up front. I don't care how good your receivers are or how explosive your running backs are. If you can't control the line of scrimmage, then it's tough to move the football.
I agree, Coach. And the thing is, this quarterback can make some plays for you if you give him enough time back there to throw.
Well, it looks like he's going to have to figure out how to make plays without time.
They line up in the shotgun.
That's easy. I know how to make plays without time.
He drops back. He steps up. He's looking. He tosses it short. Got it to the senior. And he's tackled. That won't be enough to move the chain.
That's what I like to see. Crisp tackling by the defense so he can't get away and get enough for the coach.
I do. No.
The Blazers are lining up to punt it away. He gets it off. Number three, Fields with the 38. And he's drilled. They're ready to start another drive, hoping to duplicate the results of the last one, which ended in a touchdown. They'll go to work at the 38-yard line. The Volunteers come out in the ace formation, rolling out to the right side. He wants it all, going long. He's got it on the run. Wow, nice catch.
Way to look it in. Heck of a job by the wide receiver. These guys are moving the ball down the field.
First and 10, ball on the 22-yard line. Tennessee goes with the ace set here. Rolls to the right. He's going right. In and out of his hand. Unbelievable.
That, my friend, is like what you see in those video games. The ball is thrown right on the money and giddy. It just bounces right off of him.
It's second down and 10 to go.
This is a video game, sir.
Number 7 comes to the line with 3 wide. There's the play fake. Looking, throws it to the outside. Touchdown, Tennessee! That was a well-drawn-up play for the wideout.
Well, they saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can take the play call there. Very impressive.
And now let's take a look at the drive summary brought to you by Pontiac.
This is good. We beat them.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff.
Boom.
He puts it deep downfield.
He ran and nailed it again.
Number 12 fields it in the end zone. Not a whole lot of success their last time out.
And all this offense has to do a better job of staying on the field and giving their defense a chance to catch their breath.
They'll set up shot at the 20. The Blazers come out in a two tight end set. On the ground with the tailback. Tackle. About 4 yards on that play. Second and 6 coming up here. Ball on the 4.
I thought this dude was out.
The Blazers come out in the ace formation.
Right when they get injured again.
Inside handoff. They'll bring him down. The running back gets 2 on the carry. It's 3rd down and 4 to go. Ball on the 26-yard line. The Blazers come out in the ace formation. Gets the ball. No, they faked it. Looks. Rifles it right side. Big opening. The 50. At the 40. At the 30. To the 20. To the 10. Goodbye. What do you think about that touchdown pass, Kirk? That was number 3, Herbie.
Well, patience is the key here, guys. What I'm noticing more and more about this guy is he's very patient with the ball, and it's resulting in some nice scores, just like we've seen today.
Andy Tack on the extra point. Time to take a look at the Pontiac drive summary. And remember, the good folks at Pontiac have been bringing you fuel for the soul since 1926. UAB, ready to kick this one off. Here's the kick. Number 21 fields it in the end zone. Down the sideline. And now it's a foot race. Touchdown, Tennessee. That was a big time return.
Woo! Did you see some of the blocks on that play?
I just broke the kick in the yard.
This special team unit feels like it can score any time.
Can you blame them?
I don't, that was 100 yards? They lying. That wasn't no 100. That was 100 yards. The blocking was immaculate. Even when he tried to hit me, then he even tried to touch me. He just ran and touched me. Yeah, that was immaculate. Can't believe I broke the yard. Kick return. His was 98, mine's 100.
And he hits the PAT. So that brings us to the end of the quarter. And at the end of three, our score, Tennessee 42, UAB 31. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the
kickoff. 5 minutes left. Hopefully, 13 minutes.
He hits a booming kick. Number 11 fields it in the end zone. Let's see if this defense has trouble defending the pass again here.
If they do, my friend, look out. They're going to give up another touchdown in a hurry.
That was an accident. They beat the giveaway a touchdown. Now shut up. Listen.
UAB comes out of the shotgun. Back to pass. Steps up. He's looking. He rolls out to the right. Going deep.
See what I'm talking about? That was a pick. That was a pick right there.
Yes, I do. With that last goal, he's thrown for over 300
yards in this game. They cheated.
I know the defensive coordinator is kicking and howling right now on the sidelines.
The Blazers come out in the ace formation. He jukes, and they got him for a loss. The D lineman wasn't letting anyone buy him that time.
And the big fella did a heck of a job plugging up the hole where that play was supposed to go.
That guy's so big, Kirk, he doesn't plug up holes. He plugs up the whole line down there.
He doesn't plug up
holes. He might have a chance. Makes a move. And down he goes. And the hat ripped off a nice gain there to get him the first.
Hey, this kid's a good-looking back. Let's see if they go to him again.
First and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. This defense is looking to their impact corner to make a play. Inside give. Has some daylight. The 5. Touchdown. There's number 2 on the day.
The coach loves to give the football to this running back. You know why? Because he knows how to find the end zone.
Yeah, go over to him. Oh, adorable.
UAB comes out with an I formation. Here's the give. There you go. And now let's take a look at the drive summary brought to you by Pontiac.
Come on, man. I'm trying to be great.
One is deep to receive, and look out, folks. He's looking to run another one back for 6. Here's the kick. Number 33 fields it in the end zone. Well, the offense heading back out onto the field after that kick, hoping to turn this drive into another touchdown. They'll get the ball here at the 20. Tennessee comes to the line, only one man in the backfield. He's rolling right. Comes across the middle. He spins, breaks one. Tackles.
Nice decision by the quarterback.
Not only was it good decision making, but the offensive line protected just long enough for him to find his target.
Actually, the offensive line did not protect me that long. The offensive line almost got me sacked.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 39-yard line. The impact player at running back is in the zone right now. Looking. Looks like he's going to run. He's hit and got away. He tries to spin, and he's taken down. He had a whole lot of room to run on that one.
When the pressure's coming from the inside and the quarterback can escape the pocket, it usually means he's going to have some room to run.
First and 10, ball on the 49-yard line. Tennessee goes with the ace set here. Drops back to pass. Looks. throws this one out to the right. It's deflected.
I tell you what, Kirk, if that receiver doesn't get more aggressive, this defense is going to be knocking the balls down all game long.
You're absolutely right. That was a heads-up play by the corner, but it would have never happened if the receiver would have come back to the ball instead of waiting for it to fall into his lap.
The ball set up in the gun.
He's not lying.
Rolls right. He's looking. He goes downtown. Hauls it in for the touchdown.
You know, it's so important as a football player to have confidence in yourself and your teammates. And a three-touchdown performance like this can really build confidence in both the quarterback and the receiver.
Tacks on the extra point. And now let's take a look at the drive summary brought to you by Pontiac. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Kicks it off. Number 11 fields it in the end zone. Thanks to some nice passing on the last drive, the offense was able to take it down the field for six.
And great play calling to help make that an easy drive. The question is, can they do it again?
They can't do it again. They're going to do it once. Cause
steps up in the pocket, looking down the middle. Number five.
Told you. Okay.
The defense was all over that pass, guys,
because they were able to get pressure here, Brad. And when you toss one up like that in the
middle
cover,
yeah.
It's an easy pick.
That was so.
And they'll look to capitalize on the good field position here.
Oh, oh boy.
They come out with a big set. Play action. Looks. Rolling out to the right side. He unloads it. Brings it in. Touchdown.
Do they have that defense guessing now or what? I mean, did you see how well the quarterback hit the ball?
Yeah, some quarterbacks are so good at selling the play action. Truly an overlooked skill. You take my friend Kirk here, for example. He wasn't known for his speed, but boy, he could do a good play fake.
Are you calling me slow? This is coming from a guy whose nickname is based on his foot speed. Isn't that right, Scooter?
Yeah, left out sunshine. It's Sunshine Scooter, sweetheart.
And he hits the PAT. So with just over 3 minutes remaining in the fourth quarter, the score is Tennessee 56, UAB 39. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff.
Oh, I missed it.
Kicks it off.
Oh, no.
Number 11 fields at the goal line.
Great passing with the key to the offense.
How many yards I got? If I get 500 yards in this game, it's over. I just broke one roof.
High formation here. Nice play fake. He's looking down the middle. Got an opening. Got it to his receiver.
I like the defense that was called. They just didn't make the play on the ball.
You're right. It wasn't necessarily bad defense. The offense just executed, and the result is a first down.
UAB lines up in a double tight set. Gets the ball. No, they faked it. Under heavy pressure. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. The fourth-year man at defensive end brings down the quarterback for the sack.
That's exactly what you'd expect out of a senior. Big plays to fire this defense up.
Got a big body.
Second down, 14. Ball on their own 30.
Buddy, you love me?
This impact tailback would love nothing more than to have the ball in his hands right now. And that one's fallen incomplete. Poor pass, and his tight end couldn't reach it. It's third down and 14 to go. Ball on the 30-yard line. UAB comes out with five receivers. Back to pass. Rolls to the right. Across the middle. It falls incomplete. He led his halfback too far on that throw.
This kid needs to relax and get the ball down where his receivers can catch it.
Five wide.
Oh, we got a wide receiver out there.
Here we go. He's looking.
You know it's gonna be a pick on the wide receiver.
Complete on the run.
No, that's some bull.
That was a sensational call.
It sure was here, guys. Usually on fourth down, you have the receiver run just enough yards to get to the marker. The defense here was looking for that, and right over their heads for the big play.
They're cheating. Look at the stats. Mostly cheating.
Brought to you by Old Spice Red Zone, when performance matters the most. Drop back to pass. Throws down the middle. Someone got a hand up. And that one was oh so close.
Close call is right. If he just put a little bit more touch on the ball, that would have been a big play. Let's give credit to the linebacker. That was an athletic play there by the defense.
I think y'all can win. Stop thinking
this impact linebacker is fired up down there. He's going left.
Well, again here, he does a great job of finding the open man, and that's touchdown number four.
Kirk, I think his arm's got to be tired by now. That's a bunch of throws, yards, and points he's put up.
And he tacks on the extra point. And here's the Pontiac drive summary. UAB lined up for the onside kick. Here goes. Spin move. So the hands team does their job, and the onside is not successful.
When people talk about special teams winning football games, they're usually talking about blocking kicks and big returns. But the onside return team can be just as important. And right now, these guys may have sealed the deal with that recovery.
Tennessee comes out with two tight ends. Looking, rolls to the left. He keeps it. He held him up. They'll bring him down. A 5-yard quarterback scramble.
I was about to say. I was about to tell him.
UAB calls a timeout. Second and 5 coming up here.
Just waste of
ball
clock.
47. Line up with two tight ends. They'll give it off here. Gets a tackler. He might have a chance. Brought down. UAB takes a timeout. It's first and 10. Ball on the 42.
Chains forward, Tony. He's hanging.
And they have 3 bunts. They'll throw on first down. Rolling out to the left side, across the middle, and he's taken down.
Way to look it in. Nice catch.
Sure was. He displayed some great hands there. Now we're looking at a first down.
Just keep the clock, man. Just keep the clock, man.
First and 10. Ball on the 31.
I'm coming back.
Tennessee comes out with 3 receivers, but looks. Across the middle. I'm not sure why they went to the air there.
Beats me. They need to run the clock.
It's second down and 10 to go. And this is the 5th play of the current drive.
Yeah, we get to see that.
And they have 3 receivers bunched. He rolls out to the right. He's looking. Got an opening. There's a missed tackle. Tackle. Third and 2. This is the 6th play of this drive. Tennessee goes with the ace set here. He's rolling right, looking. He's going right. Finds a man. Have a look at our Old Spice Red Zone numbers. Red Zone, when performance matters the most. Their last red zone trip resulted in a touchdown. I don't expect this one to be any different. Again with the run, and they make the stop. UAB calls a timeout. The ball line up with 3 receivers bunched. Looks. Here they come. Touchdown, Tennessee. That's his 3rd touchdown on the ground, fellas.
No, easy. coming back. Yeah, I'll come back, but y'all not coming back.
And he hits the PAT. Time to take a look at the drive summary. It's brought to you by Pontiac. Fuel for the soul. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. Number 11 fields it in the end zone. Now the offense is back on the field again. In their last drive, they moved the ball very well, especially through the air on their way to that touchdown.
It's 19 degrees.
Blazers set up in the gun. And he is drilled. They'll give him an inch or two, if that.
Yeah. They're setting up. They're trying to go 49, 48, 47, 46, 45.
Two tight end set. Here's a little draw play. And he's tackled. Back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it. The impact corner is in the zone right now and looking to take away half the field. He's hit and got away. Tackle. That was a great call.
Yeah, here you see the draw play at its best. The tailback got good blocking up front and was able to pick up a bunch of yards.
UAB lines up in a double tight set. Draw play brought down. Not a lot on that one. No gain
on the play. I'm trying to go cheap on, just go running it. Because you're going to score.
Comes out with two tight ends. A little juke. He's gobbled up in the backfield. Drop back a yard.
Seven. Six, five, four, three, two, game.
UAB goes with the ace set here. He gets another carry. And he's going to lose yards on this one. And this ball game's over. Kirk, any final thoughts here?
You know, I think it was a well-played game for the most part. UAB probably feels they should have won this game, but they just didn't make enough big plays when they needed to.
Folks, that's going to do it for this edition of NCAA Football 2006. We hope you all join us again.
That was a good game. I'll see y'all later when I come back. If I come back to Nick Clem.